Hi guys, the plan is to make this today. This is part two, and this is part one, which will come in the middle on the top. But you gotta be careful, because when this goes around, you will notice that one part will be shorter than the other. So you gotta make sure that when you do part two, part one and part two will equal up when it's around your wrist. Now, even though this might look simple, because basically it's the same as that we did here, it took me an awful long time to figure out how to get the loops like that. So I'm going to show you. I got about an arm span and a half wide, and I probably have left over. I have no idea how much you need. People keep asking me how much will I need, but well, look at this little tiny wrist. I don't know how much you need. You might be twice the size, but I think an arm span and a half of soutache will be okay, because I'll think I have plenty left over, and I just reuse that in other projects later on. Like, I don't know if I ever showed this all the way, but this is finished. This is where your leftover soutache goes in. These are the kind of projects you can use for leftovers. I still need to do the back though. As you can see, it's all taped up, but I still need to put the backside on there. Anyway, so that's what you do with leftover soutache. So don't worry about it. If you got too much, just don't throw your little pieces away. And the weather is a little bit dark outside, but I guess autumn kicked in really bad today. A lot of rain going on. So I got about an arm span wide of fireline. This time I'm going to use white, but it basically works the same. Let me get my green pad. So you can see where my white thread is going. And you're going to start off leaving a considerable amount of soutache. I got orange, which is my slippery, shiny one. Forget to tie a knot. Just go in there. And as I said before, your thread needs to go through like it feels like it's going into butter. I have 6mm pearls, and this one is going together with this one. I have 6mm pearls. These are the ones from Preciosa, but it's gotta be a little bigger. You have to have a little bit of a bigger loop, so you need also a bigger bead. So that's why I have 6mm. And to not make it that heavy, I just used 6mm, but you can also use the 8mm. Now we're just gonna go straight up. One straight line to get our first pearl in there. And this is basically just how you started the other one. But I figured it was really easy, you know, just do the same, make bigger loops. But then sometimes your mind is just very confusing, and it just boggled my mind, and I've been practicing how to make those loops bigger for, like, I think 3 or 4 hours till I finally figured out how to do them. So you might already understand it, but I'm going to show it anyway, just in case your mind is a little boggled also. You can say I can do this because you already done it with the other one, but I don't know. I just couldn't get it. And sometimes, you know, you just stare yourself blind on certain things when it comes to beading, and you just don't get it. Somebody can tell it to you 100 times, show it to you 100 times, and you just don't get it. And most of the times that actually has to do with being tired or wanting to rush. But I'm going to show you anyway. So we now need bigger loops. And we're just going to go straight for a bit. working our way up. And because we need big loops, we need to go straight for like a considerable amount of space there. And then after that, we'll start with our first loop. I think we're pretty much there. Now we're gonna pre-curve. And you need, the curve needs to be a little bigger now. So if you have a problem figuring out how big that curve will be, just kind of put your purl in there and then you'll see. Like, okay, that big. Putting the purl in there. Oh. Going to the other side. Pushing that purl up. Going back in there and getting that on the right spot. Now we need to go down and we need to remember we need to make a big loop. So now the loop. It's got to become bigger, like that. And you just do diagonal and straight to the other side. Like you did with the other one. And also here, the first one is really hard to do, because you got to determine how big that loop needs to be. But that loop needs to be pretty big. Before you can close it up. So now you check, because you want your purl to come out on the other side, of course. So that other purl needs to be about here. So a little further down. Before you close up. And I think you pretty much got your loop now. So we'll go one more up. And now we're going to close it. One. And this works the same way. Two. Three and four, and turn it around, go a little further up. And take the curve. Now, this is very important. Your first curve, of course, needs to be determined that everything is in the correct place. So, you might want to check that again. Okay, maybe you want that curve to come down a little bit more. Already in the curve, so just make sure that you got like the size that you want. Maybe you want that purl to come on out just right underneath there, but I wouldn't suggest that because I got plans to get rid of some extra leftover beads. So you got to give it a little bit of room because those extra beads are going to come in between here. So that's about it. Curving. And it's very important also not to pull your thread too tight, because if you pull it too tight, then your soutache will look horrible. I made the mistake, so I rather have like a little, let me show you that, if I can show you that, little loop of thread left over like this with a curve that looks nice. And we're gonna decorate the outside anyway, so you don't have to worry about that. Those threads won't show anymore when we're done. So, putting in the last one. adding my purl, and I'm gonna go to the other side, and I think I'll just for extra security take the other four, the other three threads with me. Go up. If I'm not in the right place, I'll just go up one more time, and I'll just go down there one more time. And then I'll grab my purl. Right here. Curve that around there and get in there. What we did with the other one was we went right underneath the Preciosa bead with our bead, with our needle. So that's what we're gonna do again. So I made the mistake of several times of connecting like this, you know, already connecting in the middle, but no, that's not the way it works. So that was something I was just kind of banging my head against the wall over. Yes, I couldn't do it right for some odd reason. So now I'm just working my way towards that other pearl. All the way diagonal. And up. And make sure you keep that space in between there until you're underneath that other pearl. And I know it's... you just want to close them up. And that was my problem also. I just wanted to close them up. But this is how it works. One more. And up. One more down. Not too far. Just the last opening. And out. Up. And now we're pretty much underneath that pearl. So we're gonna go underneath the pearl right there. And one. And two. And three. And four. And now you turn it around again. And let me see. This is what you're gonna get. So that's about the space that I want. As you can see, I got about the same kind of space on this one. So I suggest you make that as long as you think you need to, and I will continue with this. Because that's already finished. Now, first we need some black fire line. Now the next part is that these need to go back somewhat to the middle, because they need to match up with these ones like this. So one goes one way, the other goes the other way, and they need to match up where they pretty much are in the middle, like that, coming next to each other. So that's what I'm going to do right here. Gonna make sure that this is all good tied, and you might have to do a couple of more than four to make sure that you get a good turn at the end. Just turn it around and flatten that out. And just make sure when you get to that middle that you do another one, like six up and down or something like that, just to make sure that that is very secure. Two. Three. Four. Five. And six. And you might want to go seven just to get to that other side with your thread. There. Now you need to fit. And this will fit. That's almost closed. But the other one also needs to fit along. So now you need to check if this the top one is long enough. Or if you maybe need to do one more loop. I just hold that. And I think I need one more loop, which will mean that both of these are coming to the other side. So I don't want to do that. So I'm just going to leave it like this. And I'll just have it a little shorter on the top because I need both threads to come on this side. If I make another loop, I would be ending up here with this thread. So I can't do that. But if you need like two more loops, then that would be okay. And I'll just decorate the sides, so there's always an answer to everything. I'm just going to make double sure I don't need two loops. If I got that there, No, that would definitely be one loop. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to find the middle, and you need some pins because this is, of course, a round project. It goes around your wrist, so you need to make sure that you find pretty much the middle and just leave it on your arm and just pinch on through there. Be careful you don't pinch into your arm. And this is just about where the middle is. And now you're just going to go all the way around. Might want to move that over a little bit more. Get that out of there. And you need to curve it while you do this because, of course, yeah, your bracelet goes around your wrist. Pinch it in there. Just get it up. Gotta make sure you're good in the middle, though. Because if you're not in the middle, then when you're gonna attach it, it's going to be attached not correctly. And I'm going in between my threads on the top. Gotta be careful you don't screw up the bottom either. Just getting those needles on the top. Okay, and then you can check again. If all is good, and then you just do the other side. And just make sure you keep curving that. Stay in the middle. Okay, and when you got all of them and everything is correct, then it should look something like this. You might have to move it over a little bit as you work, but that's okay. Now, that's our cuff right there. We need thread because you can't wear a bracelet with needles in them, of course. So we have to attach both sides with thread. So I'm going to pick that up in the very first one. Make sure that keeps curved. Very important. Pull the thread through there. And I'm going to go down, and I'm carefully going to find the soutache on the other side. Going up again, and I'm going to go through the middle. I make sure that you're in between that soutache. Going down. Coming out from under the second preciosa bead. And I'm going back in the middle, down into my soutache on this side. It's a bit of a spaghetti thing here, but we can't finish up the ends until we got the whole bracelet attached. Going up again into the back. You gotta just check your back and make sure that you're somewhere in between the red underneath the preciosa bead again, and just go in between to that other side underneath that other bead. And just do them one by one, attach them one by one. You can take out the first one right here. Gotta go back in your blue into your soutache underneath and just check if you're in there. As you can see, I'm in there. Coming back up in the soutache in between the blue. Crossing over to the other side. Right here. Into the middle of the red. Into the soutache. Check. Yes, I am there. Might have to move that over now and then a little bit. Come back in between the red. It's hard, it's hard. Pull it through. Back into the red. Crossing over to the blue one. Going down in blue on the side into the soutache, I hope. Yep. So that's basically how you attach the second part. You go back into the soutache, try to come up from in between the blue and the yellow in this case. So I'm up from the blue, going into the blue, looking for that middle again. Coming out of the red middle. Down in the red middle into the soutache, and I'm there again. This is a little bit of a tedious job, but it's gonna look smashing when we're done. So, up in between red and yellow again, getting in between there, crossing over to that other side, into the blue. and there, that's all attached. So I suggest you finish that up. And when you're done with that, we're going to take care of these buggers here. And after that, we're going to embellish. Okay, I have my cuff. Everything is tightened up. Okay, and it really looks pretty like that already. But that's not what I wanted. I wanted to heavily decorate. And for that, we first need to get the black threads out of the way. So right now I want to get back to the threads and just kind of get the thread over here so you can start decorating over there. And you just need to find a way to get there. Going down in between. Actually, in between there is where I want to be for now with this thread. And because I want to make an adjustable clasp, I need to get this one away from there too. So I'm going to stick this thread through and come on out, hopefully somewhere in between red over there. Okay, so we got my threads out of the way, and I'm going to pick up these six braids. And these six threads, and basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the middle ones together, the green and purple, and I'm just going to simply braid it. I'm going to start with the top one. Braiding that together. Nice color combination, by the way, when everything comes together. Sure, my braid is somewhat straight. I'm going to braid that as far as possible so I can make a good knot. that's it. And then we're just going to grab it over here and do the knot like that. And just pull that knot down until you're out of that braided area. Like that. And now we do the other side. It's really pretty. The same way. So first we're going to get the threads out of the way. This is an end thread, so that needs to go. Or actually a beginning thread. So that needs to be cut off. Two knots, and now we decorate. And for this, I have leftover beads, and these are the beads I find on, you know, projects unfinished that I need to take apart, beads I find on the floor. It's just all kinds of beads, and if they are not colory enough to my taste, then I will add some other beads in between there. So first that means I need to get a couple of projects apart so I get a nice assorted bunch of leftover beads. So I got all kinds of crappy beads here, and the threads are still among them because most of them are projects taken out, and I really don't want to put them back to where they belong in their little bags. But in case there are some that I don't want to use, like my white bicones, I don't want to use the white bicones on there. I don't think it will look good. And there's a Monty in there and some gold 8-0, so I still need to use that, so I won't be using this. And as I sort through those, I will get those out because those are precious to me. And I will need them again a little later on. So I'm picking up my leftover thread that is on my project. Putting my needle on there. And basically what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pick up some beads. And it doesn't really matter what you pick up. And I'm going to go, I got like four beads on there with a cube. I'm gonna go back into the cube and the other beads and pull that tight. Now that's gotta come all the way down, so you gotta make sure that that last seed bead gets tightened up. And what I basically wanna do is I wanna just go down and decorate all around the edges of the circle there. And that might mean you can't go, or I don't want to, maybe you can, but I don't want to go in between here and get my needle out like that, because I don't want to damage that thread anymore. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back in between the soutache on the side, and in order to get that a little bit around like that, I'm going to pick up a couple of seed beads. I'm going to go into that seepy over there. Gonna pick up a couple more, and then I'm gonna go into the soutache over here. And that's basically what I'm be doing, back in the soutache on the side. And I want to fill up this gap, so I'm just gonna go into this seed bead over here. I'm gonna pick up another seed bead first, because you don't want to see thread. Going into that seed bead. And then I'm going to get a red one, and I'm just going to stick it into the soutache again. And I also don't want to cover my pearls, but you can take it as high as you want to. So I've got that over there, and now I'm going to pick up a couple of them, go in here. Get back up. Picking up Swarovski's 3mm, why not? Going into the red. And when I pick up a bugle, I make sure that my thread doesn't touch the bugle, so I got a seed bead, a bugle, and two seed beads. And I'm going back into seed bead, bugle, seed bead. And I just pull that down. And I'm going into picking up another seed bead. Going back into the bigger white one here. And I can pull that down later. So right now I'm just going to go into the cube over here. And it's just basically going from one place to the next. Picking up some more beads. Sticking it into the soutache, coming back from the soutache, going into the seed beads, one of them, and now I'm going to pull that one down. So, picking up about four. I'm going to just put that on top of there. Picking up some more. And just going in here. And what I basically want to do is I want to make sure that all these holes are covered so you don't see anything in between there. And if you see thread here, you might want to go a little bit. You see the black thread here? I want to cover that too. But we can't do it all at once, so I'm first going to do this part and then later see what I still need to fix up. And that's just basically what I'm going to do until I reach the other end. So, of course, you can decorate it more pretty and more decent, and but I kind of like this. It will give a nice touch to that. So, I would say just decorate it, and you can even go over here so you won't see that area, that it doesn't look that good, as long as you make sure you don't go over the straight area where the braiding starts. So this is what I got so far, and I'm running out of thread, so basically what I'm doing is I'm going to go back through beads and, you know, just go through a lot of beads so that thread is all tied up and won't come loose. Working my way back, basically. And then I'm going to add a new thread. But I think I will work away the thread on the other side first, because that way you don't have too many threads going around in your projects. Might as well get that done. So I think it's pretty safe over here. And now I start here. Finish up that thread before I start a new one. It will also give you an immediate idea of what it's going to be looking like when you just go on the other side also. And sometimes it flips under, and then all you have to do is come back up, get a bead, and then flip it back up, basically. So I'm going back and forth. And then just working my way forward. But yeah, it's pretty much back and forth. Adding a Swarovski in between now and then, on top of everything. And moving forward again. Bead, going into there, because I do like it when it comes in between now and then. I did one here too, so that's kind of cool too. But you know, it's whatever basically you want to do. I don't have too much thread on this side, but that's okay. Work it away. Adding a new thread works the same way as when you do the soutache. Just go into the soutache and just go through some beads before you add a new set of beads. And maybe it's a good idea to go just under the threads and make a little loop to go into, and do that about two times before you start adding new beads, and that will secure everything. And now I can add more beads. Yay! As I've reached the other side, I'm now also going to attach this part and just decorate over it so that everything is very secure here and that braid won't be going anywhere.